and welcome to the introduction to the HVM 200 vibration meter from Larson Davis. This particular instrument will work with either hand, arm, whole body, or general vibration measurement tools. In this particular instance, we're using a hand arm accelerometer. So we have attached this using Allen key and screw onto a standard handle mounting block. I would normally suggest using a standardised mounting block where we can tubally clip onto the tool. To attach the accelerometer to the device itself is via the integrated cable, CBL217, and you can wear the device on the arm and use the instrument to monitor. So this could be worn further up the arm, somewhere up here, and then have the accelerometer based inside your hand. So that's the case to go on the arm. Now, to attach the accelerometer to the instrument, we can take the accelerometer. There is a notch on the side of the accelerometer which will line up with a black notch on the side of the cable. Push it into position and then screw into position on the accelerometer. It is important you get finger tightness on here, not too tight or else we'll never be able to remove it from the accelerometer, but finger tightness. And then there is a similar technique for attaching to the unit itself. The instrument itself, the HVM 200, has only one single button of operation, which is on the top of the instrument, and then gives you some advice about in terms of the power LED, which is this LED, and the status LED on the side. So to turn the instrument on and off, it's press and hold the button here and then remove. We happen to be in an on position. We can also manually run start and stop using this button, so a single button operation. So we'll start off by turning the instrument on. That's now in an on position. So one of the key features of the HVM 200 is our ability to review it via a mobile device. So in this case, I happen to have a iPad Pro here, and the first stage is to connect up to its personal Wi-Fi hotspot. So I can see the HVM 200 here, so I can connect to that. Select the HVM 200, my iPad will then go and have a look. And then if I open up the HVM 200 utility software, I can now see the serial number of the instrument I wish to connect with. So 00129 is where we're looking. So I can then open up the software here. This is where I can do any measurements. So I can review any measurements, so I can see anything that's going on with the instrument. So the instrument is not in operation at the moment, but if I did want to start a measurement, I'd press the play button down at the bottom here. And it also gives me some general instrumentation settings. So if I press play, I can begin a measurement with the device. So we now see we're getting some vibration levels by the Wi-Fi connection from the accelerometer here. We can scroll through. This also happens to have a variety of different options, so we can see our peaks, any of our measurement criteria live going on in terms of our vector sum value. Scroll across again, I can see my individual axes of vibration, X, Y, Z, and then we're back to our overall data. So if we want to stop a measurement, we just simply press the stop button, and then that's now stopped. And we can annotate that measurement if we want to put any notes in for that particular measurement function, so cancel to look in there. We can also interface with the instrument to look at any particular settings, do a calibration check, look at the file manager, set up the Wi-Fi networks and general information about the instrument. So to look into the about, we'll get our general legal information, any firmware updates, etc., when it was manufactured. We can, in here, if we look at the setup for the Wi-Fi, we can set up to any Wi-Fi networks to access the instrument. We can look at our file manager, so any preset files we can review via the app. We can also go into our calibration check. So if we had a shaker or we wanted to do some calibration and wanted to set some references, we could use a calibration check via this system. We can also check the general instrument settings, so enable any particular settings we want to have on this particular device. So we've got some presets available, so in terms of 1 second logs, 60 second logs, comfort settings, standard hand arm, seat settings, and a variety of different options available here that we can pull out or have our own presets. We can look at the operating mode, be it hand arm, whole body or general vibration settings, our storage and interval time, whether we want to store any of the raw data to interface with things like MATLAB, etc. We can enable a scheduled start and stop time for the instrument and what the run duration might be. Any miscellaneous settings like adding octave band history. So I will enable octaves and third octaves on this device just so we can show you what we've got there and save that setting. Yes, I would like to apply those changes. We can look at any tools. So we can look at the display units, whether they're in G, meters per second square, centimeters per second square, etc. Now, ordinarily, we'd be using meters per second square for hand arm vibration measurements. We can look at any sensor settings, so we can change the sensitivities of the particular sensor we might be using. We can look at any of the general options that are installed on the device. So octaves and third octaves and raw data are all optional extras that you can have with the device. Or we can look at our Wi-Fi settings, so we can see I'm connected via the access point at the moment.
Alternatively, you can go and visit our website at www.safetymonitors.co.uk or do give us a call on 01489 890 458 between 9 and 5 Monday to Friday, or outside of normal working hours, please do give us a call on 07951 854 824. We're here when you need us, and we understand that the normal 9 to 5 day doesn't always apply. So please do feel free to give us a call. Thanks for visiting, and we hope to see you again soon.